computer geek. He's a technology guy, but he really gets his kicks out of flying this these Pitts aircraft. He got his private pilot certificate, commercial rating, instrument rating, and then he became a CFI. And there goes Spencer Suderman and the Meteor Pitch climbing up to gain energy for his routine. He's going to start out by climbing up and gaining altitude to kick everything off with an inverted flat spin. I watch these guys fly these aircraft. I've been up for a couple of aerobatic rides. I just don't know how they do it without getting sick.
I don't know how they do it either. Now,
well, we're going to see each kickoff take a little bit of unusual attitude and spin training. That's where if you're required to do a little bit of this when you're learning how to fly, he did it. He really took a liking to it. And that's when he decided he wanted to become an aerobatic pilot. He discovered that aerobatics are amazingly fun, and he quickly lost interest in flying straight level like you and I like to do. After he went to a few aerobatic contests in the Super Decathlon, which is another aerobatic aircraft, he decided to go to the high performance level and move up to the Pitts S2B. I've lost sight of him there. As I mentioned, he's gaining altitude and energy to start off for the inverted spins. And while he's up there, the winds are pretty strong up at altitude. He's sure certainly evaluating how he's going to work his strategy to maintain show center for the optimum viewing pleasure for all of our spectators. Now, Spencer's certainly a fun-loving guy. I've gotten to know him for a little while, and his enthusiasm for flight is infectious, and I'd love to go fly with him sometime. You can, too. Contact him on his beasafepilot.com website. If you want to get some instruction or be a thrill seeker and just go have a good joyride, Spencer's happy to go do it. Now look as the aircraft almost stops in the sky there, fighting through that headwind. As he continues to climb up into the Southern California skies, gaining energy and altitude for the first maneuver there. He's really going to uniquely showcase the capabilities of this one-of-a-kind Meteor Pitch biplane. And you're going to see the intense gyroscopic maneuvers. Dying down, rolling the plane up, taking a look at the show center, making sure it's in the right location. All right, the smoke is on, ready for the inverted flat spin with a signature corkscrew smoke trail as the plane drops at over 6,000 feet a minute. Spencer's going to take us through 14 different maneuvers today. Now look at that as the smoke goes on. Let me tell you a little bit about that smoke oil, folks. Yes, it is environmentally neutral. It doesn't damage the environment. It is simply a paraffin-based oil that they put into the exhaust, the hot exhaust. It just causes it to whiten up and give you a nice view of where the aircraft is. No animals were harmed in the producing of this smoke oil. All right, Spencer comes out of the inverted cork, the inverted spin from 4,000 feet. Accelerates the aircraft off to the right. Like Bill's aircraft, 260 plus horsepower Lycoming IO 540, 540 cubic inch. Rolling on the downline as he gains airspeed right back towards show center. Spencer will pull up into the vertical, doing what is my favorite maneuver that he and Bill do. Only a handful of guys do it, called the double hammerhead or the pinwheel. Watch as the aircraft puts in full left rudder, corkscrews the aircraft back across, and back on down, mastering the aircraft in that axis. Down on the down line, he accelerates to the left, pulls into the vertical to work back in a maneuver called the Humpty Bump. Humpty Bump is basically a fancy word for a vertical. Go into the vertical and reverse back towards the show center while you're gaining energy. As he comes back on the down line here, he'll accelerate the aircraft to its maximum speed, go into a 6G pull here, into a loop. This is actually an avalanche, folks. There he goes, the start of the loop. At the top of the loop, he'll go full left rudder, stick full left, snapped the airplane once. There it is, bam, right into the snap, right back to the inverted, and he comes back down to complete the avalanche. Accelerating out to show right. He sets up for a hammerhead. Right as the aircraft is about ready to run out of airspeed again, full left rudder, pitch that nose on down, get the mass of that engine pouring downhill, accelerating on down to get the airspeed available to be able to pull the 6 to 7 Gs that he needs. Now with a ratchet roll, showing the unique crispness of the aileron. Back to the left, stop it, back to the inverted, stop it, back to the wings level. Look at him go in the ratchet roll, then a continuous aileron roll as he moves to the left. Folks, that is Spencer Susan in the Meteor Pits, also from Camarillo, California. Okay, here we go, folks, as Spencer pulls into the vertical. I think he's going to go for the tail slide right here. Bring the aircraft up there, park it in the sky, the smoke is off. He stops it in the sky, settling it back on, reverse the flight controls as he goes back into his smoke. The plane flips back down as the mast decides to take itself back to Earth and he pulls out of the dive. The next maneuver was named after a German pilot by the name of Max Immelmann. Now Max designed this maneuver where he could escape from an aircraft that was on his tail by pulling up into the vertical and not pulling through, just doing what Spence is doing, climbing up and heading out the other way. And Max would use that maneuver to get away so that he could come back and fight another day when he had more of an advantage. Told you earlier that Bill and Spencer will get together here in about an hour. We're going to see the Aerobatic Racing Challenge coming up. Again, Bill and Spencer will be over here near the announcers area after the show or during the show after their performance. So make sure you come on by and meet them and get their autograph if you'd like to. There he goes with a tumble Lomshavak. Look at that. Full left on that. And he finishes out just beautifully into the inverted as he pulls back on through. As we were telling you earlier, the Lomshavak is the Czechoslovakian slang word for a hangover or a headache. That would give me a headache just watching that maneuver. Folks, 1972, the great Charlie Hillier did this maneuver right here to win the world championship, the torque roll. It had never been done in competition before. He absolutely blew the judges away, and the U.S. team in the Pitts biplane won the 1972 world championship in Europe, the aerobatic world championship. And Spencer's accelerating back over to, looks like he's going to pull into a Cuban 8 there, half Cuban 8, as he prepares the aircraft for his one last pass, the photo pass. He'll put the aircraft, bank it up on the left wing, full top rudder, and give you a nice shot with your camera there. So stand by for a couple good shots from Spencer Suderman. And that beautiful red Meteor Pits looks like a meteor streaking through the sky.